So from here, we're moving on to the eyes themselves. Eyeshadows of this era kind of vary from the purples and pinks and greens and blues. Something nice and pastel, something that goes with your eye colour or with the dress that you're wearing. So today's palette for me today, ladies, is a pink and purple palette. I'm using from the Clinique range. So as you can see, they tend to give us a nice little palette there depending on your taste. Eyes, ladies, we really want to try and exaggerate or bring out the eyes, make the eyes look nice and big. So we want to try and enlarge them as much as we can. So what I'm going to start with is I'm going to start on the actual lid itself is a nice pale pink. Just so that it gets a little tiny bit of shimmer there, but not too much, because as I say, during the day in the 1930s, they didn't tend to use too much shimmer on the face. And with the eyeshadow extends actually all the way to the eyebrow in this era. Just with the pale one though, don't go dark up there, otherwise you look like you've got two holes burned to the blanket. Now that I've applied the pale pink, I've done it to both eyes, it's nice and pale there. I'm going to move into the crease of the eye, which is when you tend to use a darker shadow, again just to exaggerate the size of the eyes. So for this one, I'm using a flatter brush, and I'm just going to work into the creases of the eye. The thing with this era as well is there was no cat's eye effect. It was more you exaggerate the center part of the eyelid here. So what I tend to do with this is just start in the center of the crease there, and then you can always work your way out if you want to. If anything, you exaggerated the center part or towards the middle here for a sleepier or more seductive eye. So ladies, so you can see that I've kind of done that to both sides now, and just put a little bit of lighter shadow again in the bottom part, on the lid, and then kind of blended it out a little bit with that also. From here, I'm just going to go the slightly darker one again so that I can exaggerate the crease even more. So we apply that like so, and then blend it in so it doesn't look like a big line on your lid, which it kind of does at the moment, but I'll try and fix that. Okay, so you can see that because I don't have much of a lid, so I want to really define that as much as I can. And then you do the same for the other side. The next thing I'm going to apply is some eyeliner, because we had these beautiful lashes in the 1930s. This is when the eyelash, the false eyelashes, really started to become popular. So I'm using a Benefits product today for I'm using liquid eyeliner. Again, because of the heat in Napier, I want something to stay for a little bit longer. So applying this, I will be coming up nice and close because my eyesight's not so good these days. So, coming up nice and close here, and just applying it on the upper lid. Apparently for this era, the thickest part of the liner was more in the center rather than on the edges like we kind of do today, to give that cat's eye look. Again, just to give you that dreamy look to the eyes. So I'm not too fussed that it's not perfect, purely because I'm going to be putting some eyelashes over the top, so you won't be seeing it all that much. But yeah, so this is just the look of the liquid eyeliner, again, just to pop the eye. What I do want to add is some white to the inner lower part of my eyes, just to make my eyes look like they're really wide open. This is actually quite a silvery white. I just love it. As you can see, I've used it a lot. Next thing to come along is the mascara. The lashes are really important. We want long, luscious lashes, and this time the lower lashes were becoming popular as well. In the 1920s, it was just the upper, but in the 1930s, the lower lashes become more popular. For this, I'm using a Benefits product called Real Lash. I find, because I've got very fine lashes, I find this tends to bring my lashes out quite a lot. So I like it a lot. So you want to try and get from the base of the lash and extend right to the end. I'm not too good an example, as I say, because my lashes aren't that long. So I tend to get the help of fake eyelashes.